Hi guys, Sci-Fi Recapped here. Before we start, warning. Spoilers ahead. Today, I'm gonna explain an intense survival movie with an amazing plot twist, called Buried. Starring Ryan Reynolds. The movie starts by showing a black screen and the sound of Paul Conroy struggling to breathe. Then he lights a Zippo lighter and realizes that he has been buried alive in a wooden coffin. He frantically shouts for help and bangs the coffin, but his efforts are in vain. Luckily, he finds a nail hanging on the top to untie the knot in his hand. Suddenly, he hears the sound of a BlackBerry phone vibrating near his feet and he immediately grabs the phone. The phone settings are Arabic, which he uses to call someone, but desperately he can't remember the phone number. He decides to call 911 and says that he is a truck driver from the United States who works for CRT in Iraq. He also tells that when they were in a convoy in Bakuba, suddenly a group of people appeared and opened fire on him and the other drivers. Unfortunately, 911 can only help the people in Ohio, not in other countries. After that, he tries to call his wife, Linda, but she doesn't pick up the phone. He leaves a message about his condition and asks the authorities for help. Later, he calls the FBI in Chicago. They ask for a full chronology of why he's buried alive. Paul then recounts the incident in more detail that while delivering food supplies in Iraq, many children suddenly threw some stones at the truck driven by him and his friends. He says that some people appeared from behind the house and started shooting at him. Finally, he passed out after being hit by a rock, and when he woke up, it turned out that he had been buried alive in a coffin. Because Paul doesn't know the location where he's buried, he asks the FBI to track his location via GPS. Unluckily, the call is disconnected. He starts looking for a signal to call his company where he works, named CRT. He is connected to Alan Devenport, the employer in his company. Sadly, while he is telling his name, the phone is disconnected again. He looks desperate about it. Soon, he receives a call from his kidnapper, named Jobber. He asks for a ransom of $5 million before 9 p.m., otherwise Paul will be left buried there. He also seeks help by calling his wife's friend, Donna. She helps him by providing the State Department phone number. After calling the number, he was connected to Rebecca Browning, who apparently can't help him due to the government policy of not negotiating with terrorists. As a result, he is given Dan Brenner's phone number. Brenner is the head of the hostage working group, who tells Paul they are working to find him, and also tells him to conserve the BlackBerry's battery life. In the middle of the conversation, Jobber calls him again and tells him that the remaining time is 2 hours 4 minutes. He asks Paul to make a video statement that he has been kidnapped. Later, the video will be used as pressure on the United States government to pay the ransom. After Paul insists that no one will pay a ransom for a truck driver like himself, Jobber lowers the ransom to $1 million. Along with the script Paul is to read, he also finds a malfunctioning flashlight, a glow stick, a flask with alcohol, and a pocket knife. Benner then implores him not to make the video that Jobber has demanded, because if the video spreads, then the situation will become more difficult. Fortunately, Benner also calms him, saying that a man named Mark White was rescued from a similar situation 3 weeks prior and is now home safe with his family. He also writes Mark White on the coffin to give him a little hope to live. Paul is frustrated again when Jobber calls him and forces him to make the video, but he still refuses. In the end, he calls his mother, who is in the nursing home, to say goodbye, but she barely remembers because of severe dementia. Paul feels irritated when Jobber demands the video again by sending a photo of his colleague, Pamela, gagged with a gun to her head. Inevitably, he makes the video by reading the script given. His fate is getting unlucky when suddenly a snake enters from the hole in the coffin, but he is able to drive away through a hole in the wooden crate side with a fire from the alcohol. After switching the language on the BlackBerry to English, he finds the BlackBerry's number, which he relays to his wife in a voicemail. After a while, Jobber sends a video of Pamela's execution, even though Paul already sent the recording. He disappointedly calls Brenner, who is upset with him for making the video, which is now being played on all major networks and has received numerous views on YouTube. Shortly afterward, distant explosions shake the area, which damages his coffin, causing it to slowly fill with sand. He is able to plug the cracked part using a cloth. His employer's legal counsel in CRT, Alan, suddenly calls him, asking him not to speak with anyone in order to keep the situation contained. His employer then begins to record the call and informs him that he has been retroactively terminated from his job earlier that same day, which is conveniently before his capture, due to an alleged prohibited relationship with Pamela. Because of this, his company will not only not take any responsibility for his capture, and he and his family also will not be entitled to any benefits or pension earned with the company. Brenner calls him again, saying that the explosions that damaged his coffin earlier were in fact F-16 bombings and that his kidnappers may have been killed. Paul begins to lose hope and makes a last will and testament in video form, leaving his wife his personal savings and his son his clothes. After a while, Job recalls demanding a video record of himself cutting off his finger, threatening his family back home by revealing their home address. He resignedly complies with this demand, cutting off his little finger. Shortly after filming the video, his cell phone rings, and he begins to hear digging and distorted voices. The voices become clearer, saying to open the coffin, and the coffin opens. It abruptly becomes obvious that he hallucinated the encounter. Brenner calls and tells him an insurgent has given details of where to find a man buried alive, and that they are driving out to rescue him. He then receives a tearful call from his wife Linda, and he assures her that he is going to be okay. As sand continues to fill the coffin to dangerous levels, giving Paul seconds left to live, Brenner calls and tells him that he and the rescue team have arrived at the burial site. Through the phone, digging is heard, but Paul cannot hear any digging around him. The team digs up a coffin and opens it, but it is revealed that the insurgent led them to Mark White's coffin, the man Brenner claimed had been rescued. Knowing that he is not going to be saved, Paul tries to calm himself down and accepts his fate. The film ends with Brenner profusely apologizing to Paul as the sand finally fills the coffin and he suffocates as the light goes out. Subscribe to watch more videos like this, turn on notifications, and leave a like to help the channel out. Thank you for watching.